All in all, 2018 was a pretty disappointing season for the Detroit Lions. However, one of the bright spots was Kerryon Johnson. And by the way, that name Kerryon is simply just perfect for a running back. But he did a couple things that I really liked. Like, take this play for example. Detroit's gonna start this off by having their left guard and tackle double team an interior lineman, and then have their center and right guard also have one-on-one matchups. After their left tackle gets done with the double team, he's gonna move up to block a linebacker, meaning assuming every Lion makes their blocks, the next closest Patriot who could be in the way is Harmon right over there. There's a couple of interesting things you're gonna see on this play. One of which is despite Malcolm Brown getting double teamed, he still does a pretty good job once the double team is off of getting in good positioning. Now Johnson has to worry about Brown potentially getting past and getting to Johnson. This also means that the hole to run through isn't going to be as big. Typically he would have liked to run just straight through it, however now he can't really do that since Brown is in the area. And also he can't just run to the other side because then now there's another Patriot who could be in the area. So this play by Brown really helps the Patriots a lot. Basically what you're going to see Johnson do here is have a double jump cut essentially, where he just jumps to his right and then to his left. Him doing that was really just a way to make sure he got past the line of scrimmage. However, the problem is now Harmon is in good position to make a tackle, because if Johnson continues to run in that direction, Harmon can be right there and make a play. However, look at Johnson on this play. Harmon is in perfect position to make a tackle if Johnson were to keep running in that direction. However, he's able to put his foot there, which really helps him move in the other way and make a cut to the right side of the screen. Despite Harmon playing that one pretty well, he's still able to get past him and pick up a first down. That's one of those things that I really like about him. It's how quick he makes his cuts. But that's not the only thing I like about him. Another thing that makes him really effective is how quick he accelerates. Like, take this play for example. Detroit's gonna have a tight end move out to block a linebacker, and they also have three other one-on-one matchups. They'll have their receiver block the cornerback on the edge, and then they're gonna send their center and left guard over to the bottom side of the screen, the lead block for Johnson. That's important because there are two Patriots in that area, and so these two blockers should be able to take out those two Patriots. This now means that if everyone makes their blocks, it could be a home run play for Detroit. However, as we all know, everything that works on paper doesn't necessarily work out in practice. Take a look at Hightower on this play. I think he actually got a little bit fooled on this play and thought it was going to be a pass, as he ends up being farther back than you would typically expect him to be on a play like this. However, that's actually going to work out pretty well for the Patriots. Because Johnson is trying to rush to the edge, now Hightower's in a pretty good position. However, despite that, look at how fast Johnson is. He just runs past Hightower. I mean, how often have you seen Hightower take a bad angle on someone? Almost never. This really is just Johnson having great acceleration that Hightower wasn't ready for. If I could pick one attribute for a running back to have, it probably would be acceleration. And since Johnson can accelerate really quickly, that really helps Detroit. But what really helps him even more is his combination of being able to cut quickly and accelerate quickly. Like on this play, for example. First thing you'll notice is this is a bit of an interesting play call, as Detroit has two fullbacks in this game. However, this is actually going to be set up very well for Detroit. As you see, they can just have one-on-one matchups on the right side of the screen, and then send Johnson to that right side of the screen, and if they make those blocks, Johnson can easily get to the outside and run for a lot of yards. However, that doesn't exactly work out as planned. As you see, Devon Godshaw does a very good job of winning his one-on-one matchup, and he's in great position to try to make a tackle on Johnson. So what Johnson's going to do is simply just make another quick cut and then run by everybody. This is really tough to do as a running back. First off, it's already a tough enough move just to make that move and get past Godshaw, but then it's even more difficult to then get back up to your full speed as quickly as Johnson does. However, he makes it look easy, and it's a huge reason they were able to have a big pickup on that play. When watching tape for him when I was preparing for this video, I think this next play was probably my favorite play from him. It starts off as play action, where Stafford is going to fake as though he's going to be handing off to Johnson, and then Detroit is going to send three offensive linemen up the lead block as it's actually going to be a screen pass. As you see, right now this play is working out perfect for Detroit. They have three offensive linemen who can block the three Dolphins in that area, and Johnson's perfectly right behind them where he could run for a lot of yards. However, one of the problems you're going to see is that a Detroit lineman is not going to do a very good job of finishing his block on this play. I'm not really sure why he felt like he had to do this, but he's going to go very low on a defensive back, which really he didn't have to do because he has so much time left because Johnson is a good 10 yards behind him. So now Johnson's momentum is taking him to the right side of the screen, which means of course the Miami defensive back has to also be running towards the right side of the screen and also further down as he's trying to make a tackle on Johnson. You'd see a lot of guys try to make a move here and try to get around that Miami defensive back. But what I love about Johnson here is he's going to instead run straight through him. I'm not even fully sure if that was the right decision. He might have been able to get more yards had he made a cut to one direction or the other. Maybe not, it's hard to tell. But the reason why I love this play so much is that how many guys do you see after picking up the first down just try to get as many yards without taking a hit? You see so many players, even running backs, after they get the first down just try to not get a hit. However, that's just not what Johnson's gonna do. If he sees an opportunity where he has leverage to try to get over somebody, he's gonna take it. On a play like this, the chances of him getting out of this tackle seem to be pretty slim. And while if he did, he would be able to pick up a lot more yards, I think it was a pretty smart decision for him to just say, you know what, I'm going to guarantee that I'm going to pick up 5 more yards by just running into you. And that's what he did, and that's what I like about him.